shedding beauty and blessing among men and in nature. May we serve thee in our fellow men. O Holy Lady, Mother of the World, Queen of love and compassion, with all our hearts we pour out our love and devotion at thy feet, and we offer ourselves as channels of thy wondrous tenderness, as agents of thine ever-ready help. We pray thee to use us in thy holy work, that we may grow like thee, our glorious Mother. O Holy Mother, Queen of our hearts, we dedicate our lives to thy service. Ave Maria. Angels and archangels, now around the Maid, where the world's Creator on her knees is laid, where she worships o'er him, God and man in one, Son of highest heaven, Mary's royal Son. Thank you. May the Lord purify me that I may worthily perform his service. In the strength of the Lord do I repel all evil from this his holy altar and sanctuary, and from this house wherein we worship him. And I pray our Heavenly Father to send his holy angel to build for us a spiritual temple through which his strength and blessing may be poured forth upon his people. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brethren, let us now lay the foundation of our temple. Christ is our foundation and our chief cornerstone. We are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God.
And are built upon
the foundation of the apostles and prophets.
Jesus Christ himself.
Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto a holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Except the Lord build the house, their labor is but lost that build it. The foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, let every one that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Christ is our foundation and our chief cornerstone. O Lord, thou hast created man to be immortal, and made him to be an image of thine own eternity. Yet often we forget the glory of our heritage, and wander from the path which leads to righteousness. But thou, O Lord, hast made us for thyself, and our hearts are ever restless till they find their rest in thee. Look with the eyes of thy love upon our manifold imperfections, and pardon all our shortcomings, that we may be filled with the brightness of the everlasting light, and become the unspotted mirror of thy power and the image of thy goodness, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, bless, preserve, and sanctify you. The Lord in his loving kindness look down upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord absolve you from all your sins and grant you the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. With praise and with prayer shall our temple be built.
To God alone be the glory.
Thank you. be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, the undivided unity, eternal, immortal, invisible, to whom be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the world. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, the undivided unity, eternal, immortal, invisible, to whom be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christe eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Glory be to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of good will. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee. We glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord Christ, alone born of the Father, O Lord God, indwelling light, Son of the Father, whose wisdom mightily and sweetly ordereth all things, pour forth thy love. Thou whose strength upholdeth and sustaineth all creation, receive our prayer. Thou whose beauty shineth through the whole universe, unveil thy glory. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord. Thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who art the strength of them who put their trust in thee, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, we commend to thy fatherly goodness those who are afflicted with this pandemic in our midst, and we pray thee to strengthen and bless those who minister to them. Through Christ, amen. We praise thee, O Lord, for the example and assistance given to us by the holy martyr Saint Alban, the patron of our church throughout the world. And we pray thee that under his protection, thy church may continually serve thee in all good works. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the King of angels, ruler of all hosts of heaven, we praise and thank thee for the help which these thy radiant servants so joyously do render unto us, and pray that we may pattern after them in purity and zeal. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. her wondrous humility and purity, hast exalted the Holy Lady Mary among the hosts of heaven. Grant that we, thy people, may so follow that her most noble example, that we may at the latter end be found worthy to serve thee even as do thy holy angels, thou who livest and reignest in glory forevermore. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, with all our hearts we praise thee for the great glory of thy most holy archangel Michael and all thy holy angels. We thank thee for their wonderful wisdom, their supreme strength, their radiant beauty, and as their resistless power is used always and utterly in thy service, so may we, following zealously their resplendent example, devote ourselves wholly to the helping of our brethren, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Teach us, O Lord, to see thy life in all men and in all the peoples of thine earth, and so guide the nations into the understanding of thy laws, that peace and goodwill may reign upon earth, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The portion of Scripture appointed for the epistle is taken from the third chapter of the book of the Wisdom of Solomon, beginning at the first verse. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and there shall no torment touch them. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken for misery, and their going from us to be utter destruction. But they are in peace. For though they be punished in the sight of men, yet it is their hope full of immortality. And having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded. For God proved them and found them worthy for himself. As gold in the furnace hath he tried them and received them as a burnt offering. They shall judge the nations and have dominion over the people, and their Lord shall reign forever. They that put their trust in him shall understand the truth, and such as be faithful in love shall abide with him. For grace and mercy is to be his saints, and he hath care for his elect. Here endeth the epistle.